Well, greetings, vinyl community. A couple of videos ago, I alluded to having made a big score at my local record shop that I wasn't able to make a video about at the time because I'd been sick. I actually got sick a couple of times, and I'm still struggling with the after effects, so I'm keeping healthy and getting my vitamin C by drinking grapefruit juice out of my Tom and Jerry jelly glass here. This was a very unusual score, though, that I made back at the end of February at my local shop, Vinyl Solution, here in San Mateo, because you do not see this kind of music ever show up in this sleepy little town. You see, you know, a lot of yacht rock and soft rock, but not stuff like this. Somebody unloaded a collection of 80s avant-garde experimental music, downtown New York sound and funk. So I'm going to start off with the wackiest of the wacky, and that is Eugene Chadbourne. Now, just take a moment to drink in this cover, because there's a lot to unpack, and you just might get the idea that this album is totally unhinged. And it is, because Eugene Chadbourne, who I first heard of him through an album called Guitar Solos 3. Guitar Solos 1, the original, was Fred Frith solo album. Guitar Solos 2 was Fred Frith with three other guitarists, so it was split up into four sections, one for each musician playing solo. And third was a compilation of a number of different artists, including Eugene Chadbourne. And apart from playing free music on the guitar, he is an exponent of his own invention, the electric rake. On this album, he does a mixture of his own compositions, such as they are, and a lot of very familiar music. It opens with a medley in C, which is 11 minutes, 25 seconds, and it goes through about 14 songs, including Always on My Mind, Whiter Shade of Pale, San Francisco Nights, Ain't Misbehavin', Imagine, TV Party by Black Flag, Misty, Dang Me, England Swings, and it just goes on. It's a completely random selection of songs. Some Guys Have All the Luck, ending up with Eugene's own The Shah Sleeps in Lee Harvey's Grave. So we get, in addition to this, he does covers of Merle Haggard, Buffy St. Marie and Phil Oakes, Bobby Braddock, and all this is mixed on with his own completely demented pieces. And this is Country Protest, to mention the name of the album, and it is dedicated to the brave people of the United Republic of American Soviet States, or Your Ass for short, in their struggle for freedom. Eugene Chadbourne is backed by the Red Clay Ramblers and the F Art Ensemble. So, Country Protest by Eugene Chadbourne. Dr. Eugene Chadbourne.
You don't have to advertise. No matter how you serve it up, it brings tears to your eyes. You can throw me out on my face, I'll just go some other place. Perhaps I'll drive across the state line.
Got three albums in this batch featuring the legendary downtown New York figure John Zorn, the guy who shows that Frank Zappa isn't the biggest collection of records in the Z section. He's got a discography that is just staggeringly huge. And the first is an album by Derek Bailey, the great free guitar player, George Lewis on trombone, and John Zorn on alto and soprano saxophones, clarinets, and game calls. Yes, there are duck calls on this. There are a number of places on this album, which is very meandering, very free, very improvisatory music that feels its way about, but always with a center, because Derek Bailey's playing has such a clarity. I can't even be sure I could call it a logic, but there's always a path that he is traveling that makes sense in its own way, even though it's completely divorced from anything in standard tonal music. In the background, you'll often hear little sounds that are being produced by one or the other of the horn players that remind me of little piglets grunting away. So if you want the sound of little piggies in the background of your music, this just might be the record for you. But as you can see, it is baseball themed, not barnyard themed. And we'll hear a little snippet of this to enjoy. Next up, John Zorn and Spy versus Spy, the music of Ornette Coleman, played hardcore style with an ensemble of two saxophones, John Zorn and Tim Byrne, bass by Mark Dresser, and two drummers, Michael Vacher and the incredible Joey Barron. The pieces, as you might guess from the hardcore designation, are all very short. There are 17 Ornette Coleman compositions on the album. There's a nice little insert here that explains where each composition comes from. Show off the artwork a bit more. This is from 1989 and it is on the Elektra Musician imprint. So that was the second of two albums featuring John Zorn. The third is OTB by Jim Staley with John Zorn. This is an album of trombone solos on side one, and on side two, duets by Staley and Zorn, who again is playing saxophone, clarinet, and game calls, and playing very little straight horn. It's pretty much entirely sound, texture, and just squealing noise from the saxophone mouthpiece detached and that sort of thing, or just playing the duck calls. The side one is a bit more, a bit less cacophonous, but they do blend together. The solo pieces include Count to Ten and Start Again, which we'll have a little sample of. Next up, the great funky jazz bass player Jamaluddin Takuma and the album Music World. You can see he's got a little postage stamp theme from around the world, and the theme is appropriate because this is music recorded in various locations on various continents. We have music recorded in Japan, music recorded in Paris, music recorded in Istanbul, not Constantinople. You got to remember that. And music recorded in New York and Philadelphia. And the sounds of those locations are incorporated into the pieces. So we have on the Japanese recordings, there is koto and samisen and traditional Japanese drums alongside the electric guitars and basses and synthesizers and drum programming and such. On Istanbul, there is saz and chanting. On the Parisian recording, there is electric mandolin for that European effect. And basically, side one is the world music side. Side two is a more mellow sound featuring a cover of The Creator Has a Master Plan, of course the classic by Pharoah Sanders, and of all things, it's signing off with One More Night by Phil Collins. This is on the Gramavision label from 1986, Jamaluddin Takuma. In the same kind of wheelhouse from 1987, Sonny Chirac Sees the Rainbow. This is on the Enemy label from Germany and features, besides, of course, Sonny Chirac on guitar, Abe Speller on drums, Melvin Gibbs on bass, Furoan Aklaf on drums, and Bill Laswell playing bass on one track, She Racerhead's High Top Sneakers. This actually starts out with a really pounding heavy metal funk piece, but as it goes on, the band starts stretching time out and becoming more spacey and experimental. This is a great album. Sonny Chirac Sees the Rainbow. Anthony Braxton collection. Anthony Braxton with the Robert Schumann String Quartet. This is exactly what it sounds like. It's Braxton playing alto with the string quartet, and it's Braxton's compositions, of course. He's got the usual sort of diagrammatic titles there. This is a recording from 1986, recorded in 1979, released in 1986, has an insert with liner notes. This is on the, again from Germany, Sound Aspects label. Thank you. This one is not from that batch of records that showed up, but I did purchase it the same day. It's one I'd had my eye on, and there were a couple of copies floating around, and this was the one. This was the one that was not scratchy. A wonderful 1968 release by Richie Havens. Richard P. Havens, 1983. This is very 1968, as you can see from the psychedelic cover effects. It's a double LP. It has a very autumnal sound to it. He does a lot of covers of the Beatles. I think there are four Beatles songs on here, all relatively recent at the time. He does Lady Madonna, he does With Little Help From My Friends. He does Dylan and Leonard Cohen songs, as well as his own compositions. So this is a folk rock album, but it is so soulful. And the soul has nothing to do with the soul music in the R&B sense, but Richie Havens' approach is just so deep and so soulful and so mature that there's really nothing else quite like it. He was a young man at this time and sounded like a very old soul. So, Richie P. Havens, 1983. This album by Steve Hillage, his album Green, and this is the edition that is on green vinyl. Here's the insert with lyrics. This is not quite as brilliant as his first couple of albums, Fish Rising and L, which are incredible, but it's a really good album with a lot of bubbly electronics and Steve Hillage's experimental guitar work. And here comes the grapefruit juice again. You can tell my voice is going away. Finally, Meredith Monk, Turtle Dreams on the ECM label. This was recorded in 1982, 1983, released in 1983, and features on side one, which is the Turtle Dreams suite, I guess you'd call it, four vocalists and four organists, including Meredith Monk in both roles, and it's basically one long evolving chant that goes through various little riffs and ideas throughout the piece, and lasts for the first side of the album. Side two is four shorter pieces with Meredith Monk on voice and keyboards, and Colin Walcott from Oregon, who he's also one of the organists on side one. He plays didgeridoo on the side two pieces of Turtle Dreams by Meredith Monk. Oh, So that was it. That was my big score. Thanks very much for watching. If you're interested in the kind of experimental music that I showed and you have not already, please do check out my own music. There's always a link in the description. This is my album from 2015, The Insect Garden, and there are a number of others on vinyl and CD. So that's it. Be well. Talk with you again soon. Bye-bye for now.